What you're looking at isn't some old retro tech museum piece. This is a real floppy disk. And that disk, it's being used today, right now, to help guide one of the most advanced aircraft ever built, the mighty Boeing 747-400. Yep. In an age where everything's wireless, cloud-connected, and touchscreen, the 747-400 still depends on a plastic square that holds just 1.44 megabytes. Less than a single photo on your phone. So why? Why are airlines still flying planes that rely on this? What's on that disk? And what would it take to replace it? Stick with me, because the answers will surprise you. Quick one for you. What's the oldest piece of tech you've come across still being used in the real world? Type it in the comments. Let's see who's got the coolest example. Every 28 days, without fail, airline engineers perform a task that feels like a time warp. They manually load up to 12 floppy disks into the plane's data loader. It's called the Data Transfer Unit, or DTU, and it lives in the cockpit. Each of those disks contains a piece of the navigation database update. This data tells the plane how to safely find its way across oceans and continents. It includes updated routes, airways, waypoints, airport info, and more. And get this, the entire nav update, around 10 megabytes. That's 10 megabytes split across a dozen floppies, a playlist on your Spotify, 50 times larger, a single high-res Instagram pic, way bigger. Imagine this, that little disk is helping steer a 400-ton aircraft carrying hundreds of people or tons of cargo through crowded skies. Mind blown yet? How did floppies end up on board? Let's rewind. The 747-400 came out in the late 1980s. It was revolutionary. The first 747 without a flight engineer, thanks to the new glass cockpit. That cockpit, all digital displays. At that time, floppy disks were the gold standard. Reliable, cheap, easy to swap. They were in every office, every computer lab, even military systems. So when Boeing and avionics companies designed the plane's systems, they built the floppy data loader right in. When the 747-400 debuted, floppy disks were considered futuristic compared to the tapes and punch cards still in use in some sectors. Here's where things get tricky. You might think, just swap it out for a USB port or a WIFI data loader, right? The thing is, airplanes aren't like laptops. Every system is certified, hardware, software, connections, everything. To replace the floppy system means replacing certified avionics hardware. That means new data loaders, rewiring, updated software. Then you need to get the whole thing recertified by aviation authorities. It's a long, expensive process. The cost? Somewhere between $1 million to $5 million per aircraft, depending on how extensive the upgrade is. Fleet-wide? For a carrier like Atlas Air with 48 freighters, you're looking at $50 to $200 million. And that's not all. Each plane could be out of service for 4 to 12 weeks during the upgrade. That's downtime, lost revenue, and many more considerations. Okay, let's get real for a second. We've all seen those headlines about cyber attacks on modern systems, from pipelines to hospitals, and yes, even airports. Now imagine trying to hack into a Boeing 747-400's navigation system. Good luck with that. Here's why. This old-school floppy system is what security experts call air-gapped. That means it's completely offline. It doesn't talk to the internet. It doesn't talk to Wi-Fi. There's no Bluetooth, no Ethernet cable. The only way to load new data is by physically bringing it to the cockpit on those little plastic disks. Think about that for a moment. To hack it, someone would literally need to sneak onto the plane with a fake floppy disk. No remote hacking from across the globe, no cyber ninjas breaking in digitally. And that's not just a happy accident, it's part of what makes legacy tech surprisingly resilient in a modern world full of cyber threats. Here's a fun fact. In 2016, it was revealed that the U.S. nuclear missile system still used 8-inch floppy disks in critical areas, partly because they couldn't be hacked remotely. Those have finally been replaced, but the lesson's clear. Sometimes, low tech equals high security. But it's not just about security. The floppy system is also reliable. These data loaders have been in use for over 30 years. Engineers, maintenance crews, and pilots know exactly how they work. There's muscle memory involved in the loading process. The procedure is so ingrained that errors are rare, and when they do happen, the system makes it easy to spot and fix them. And guess what? While you might think floppies are fragile, in aviation, they're handled with extreme care, kept in climate-controlled storage, protected from dust and moisture, and replaced frequently. There's another advantage that's rarely talked about: predictability. Modern systems are fantastic, fast, efficient, packed with features. But with complexity comes more potential failure points. The floppy loader? It does one thing: load nav data, and it does it the same way every time. No surprises, no software updates changing the process, no compatibility issues between systems. Oh, and in case you're wondering, yes, there are still companies making floppies just to supply aviation, industrial machines, and certain government systems that never transitioned off them. If you ever wanted to buy a pack, you still can, though prices have gone up as production shrinks. So who's still using these floppies in 2025? Let's break it down. Lufthansa, 8 passenger 747-400s, Atlas Air, 48 freighters, UPS Airlines, 13 freighters, Cargolux, 11 freighters, Air Atlanta Icelandic, 6 jets, Rossiya, 1 passenger jet. That's over 80 aircraft across major airlines and cargo operators, and every single one still using floppies for their nav updates. But here's the real question: why haven't these airlines upgraded? First up, cost. We're talking $1 million to $5 million per plane to retrofit the data loading system. Now imagine Atlas Air looking at its 48 freighters, a bill of at least $50 million, and that's before factoring in the downtime. And remember, these 747-400s are workhorses near the end of their service life. Spending millions on an old jet just doesn't make sense when they're already planning to retire or replace them in the coming years. Each plane would be grounded for weeks or months for the retrofit, during which it isn't making money hauling passengers or cargo. For cargo operators like UPS or Atlas, that's a huge revenue hit. In logistics, time literally is money. These systems work. They're certified, trusted, and familiar. Airlines have no incentive to open up a can of worms by tinkering with avionics that pass safety checks and do the job. There's also the air gap security we talked about earlier. No modern connections means no modern hacking risks. The simplicity of the floppy system means fewer failure points and fewer headaches for maintenance teams. So the next time you see one of these giants roaring down the runway, remember, behind that modern exterior is a piece of vintage tech quietly doing its job. Because for these airlines, it's not just about being modern. It's about what works, what's safe, and what makes business sense. Floppy disks won't last forever. As the 747-400 fleet retires, and it is retiring fast, the floppy will disappear from the cockpit. A few operators have explored replacing the drives with USB emulators that act like floppies. But that's rare, because again, cost, certification, and limited remaining life of the aircraft. The U.S. military and certain nuclear facilities only phased out floppies from some critical systems in the last few years. Let's put this all in perspective. A Netflix HD episode, 1,500 megabytes. A Spotify playlist, 500 megabytes. A single phone photo, 12 megabytes. The 747 nav update, 10 megabytes. So next time you snap a pic at the airport, remember, your phone photo is bigger than the nav data guiding that giant jet across oceans. So there you have it, the story of how a little plastic square from the 1980s still keeps some of the world's most advanced planes flying safely in 2025. A relic of a different era, still doing its job day after day. I'd love to know your take. If you were running an airline, would you keep the floppies or would you spend the millions to upgrade? Let's discuss in the comments. And if you're into hidden tech stories like this, the kind of thing that makes you say, "Wow, I had no idea," hit that subscribe button. There's plenty more where this came from.